So you want me to walk my hand? Okay. Ready? I should probably put on my glasses then so I could see. All right. Ready? Okay. Good evening, everyone. We'd like to welcome each and every one of you to our service this evening. Those of you that are here with us in the sanctuary and to those of you that are listening online. We have a special Singspiration this evening. There is glory in going on. And we know that when you're in a storm, you don't stop. You continue going. So we want to encourage you tonight with the songs and the poems to continue going on. The Bible tells us, let everything that hath breath praise the Lord. Praise ye the Lord. And we thank God that we're all here tonight. We're well, we're in our right minds, and we can praise the Lord. So despite what challenges we may be facing, what's going on in the world, different situations, let's forget about ourselves and concentrate on Him and praise Him. So let us worship Him and praise Him this evening in the beauty of holiness, because we know when we glorify God, He will draw all men unto Him. So I'm going to impose on you to reverently stand again as we have the opening prayer. And I'm wondering if I can call on Sister Linda Baker Rankin to come and lead us in the opening prayer.
Let us pray. Our most gracious, eternal, heavenly Father, we pause this evening, O Lord God, just to give you thanks for who you are, O Lord God. We're giving you thanks, O Lord God, for the blessing of life, O Lord God, that we're all alive and well, O Father. And we're here again, O God, to worship, O Lord, and to praise your wonderful name, O Lord God. Father, this service, O Lord God, is a service of praise and thanksgiving, O Lord, with songs and poems, O Father God. We pray, O God, even in this service, O Lord, that someone, O Father, will come to you, O Lord, and come to know you as their personal friend and Savior. We pray, O God, for those who have to render their parts. We ask you to encourage them, O Lord. And, O Heavenly Father, bless the chairperson, O Father, she do her part. We ask you, O God, to continue to encourage Sister Latasha, O Father. Continue to strengthen her, O Father. Bless her and her family as well, O Lord God. We pray that you hasten the feet of those who are on their way, O Father God. Let this service be a blessing, O Father, as Sister Kay and Sister Chastine has put it together, O Father. We pray, O Father, that we too can sit, O Lord, and enjoy it, O Heavenly Father. We pray, O Lord, that those who are on the line, O Father God, that it will also be a blessing to them, O Father God, that they too, O Father, can draw something either from the songs or from the poems, O Father. And, O Lord God, if they have not made that all-important decision, we pray that they will do so, O God, very soon. Father, when we look around us and look at what's happening, O Lord, just in our island alone, O Father, time, O Lord, is promised to no one, O Father. Every day, O Father, we're hearing of someone passing, but we're asking you, O Lord, to help us to be ready when our time come, O Father God, that we, O Lord, will be prepared and ready to meet our Maker, O Father God. Help us, O Lord God, that we do not hear those words, O Father, depart from me, I know ye not, O Lord God, that the sweet words that you have written in the Bible, O Lord. Welcome, O Heavenly Father. O Lord God, we're dying to hear those words in our ears, O Father God. So help us prepare ourselves, O Father God. Bless us as a church, O Father God, we pray this evening. We ask that you bless each one, O God, who worship in the sanctuary, O Lord, and continue to help us there, Lord, that you remain true and faithful, O Lord, as we worship you in spirit and in truth. We pray for our island, O Father. We pray, O Father, that you continue to keep your hands upon our three islands that we so dearly call home, O Lord God. Continue to bless us and cover us, O Lord God. Father God, we leave everything into your capable hands. Everything will be done here this evening, be done in order, O Lord, but to the glory of your name. So we ask, O Father, that you continue to be with us. Bless those who are here, your old Heavenly Father, and bless those who are also on their way, O Father God. We want to give you thanks in your precious name. Amen.
We continue on with our program this evening. Our opening chorus is going to be your grace and mercy. And Sister KK will lead us in that.
I'm going to ask you all to stand again for me, please. Your grace and mercy brought me through.
I'm living this moment because of you. I want to thank you.
Because of his grace and mercy, if you think it was your alarm clock or the roosters crowing or your neighbor's lawnmower or the blower or the traffic or whatever other noise it was that woke you up this morning, think again. It is of the Lord's mercies. It's his will. So it doesn't matter if your alarm clock go off, the rooster making noise, the lawnmower going. If God decided he's not going to wake you up, you won't be awake. So it's because of his grace and his mercy why we are all here. And we thank God for his continued grace and mercy. At this time, we're going to have our unison reading, which is taken from Psalms 61. If you have your Bibles, you can turn there with me. And I think it will be on the screen also. Sister Fifi, Sister Desiree, yes, Psalm 61. Okay, let us begin. We'll read in unison.
Hear my cry, O God, and attend unto my prayer. From the end of the earth will I cry unto thee. When my heart is overwhelmed, lead me to the rock that is higher than I. For thou hast been a shelter for me, and a strong tower from the enemy. I will abide in thy tabernacle forever. I will trust in the covert of thy wings. For thou, O God, hast heard my vows, and thou hast given me the heritage of those that fear thy name. Thou wilt prolong the king's life and his years as many generations. He shall abide before God forever. O prepare mercy and truth, which may preserve him. So will I sing praise unto thy name forever, that I may daily perform my vows. May the Lord continue to add a blessing to the reading of his holy word. Yes, we live in a world where many times our heart can become overwhelmed. But we know that God is our rock. And as the songwriter said, on Christ, the solid rock, I stand. All other ground is sinking sand. So let us remember that we have a high priest that we can go to anytime we're feeling overwhelmed. The choir will now favor us with a song, Nothing Here to Hinder Me.
Thank you, choir, for that beautiful song. Nothing here to hinder me. We have lots of hindrances here, family hindrances, sickness, finances, environmental, all sorts of hindrances we have here. But you know, whatever we have to go through here will be nothing compared to when we make it home and we see Jesus. So we have our hindrances, we know, to go through. But he said, be of good cheer. He has overcome the world. So let us endeavor in our hearts and in our mind not to let anything hinder us from making heaven our home. Sometimes we forget it when we're going through the trial, but we have to continually remind ourselves. At this time, we're going to have a poem by Sister Gina. Be of good cheer, Sister Gina.
Good evening, church. Amen. Be of good cheer, there's nothing to fear. Cheerful thoughts like sunbeams lighten up the darkest fears. For when the heart is happy, there's just no time for tears. And when the face is smiling, it's impossible to frown. And when you're high-spirited, you cannot feel low down. For the nature of our attitude towards circumstantial things determines our acceptance of the problems that life brings. And since fear, dread, and worry cannot help in any way, it's much healthier and happier to be cheerful every day. And if you only try it, you will find, without a doubt, a cheerful attitude, something no one should be without. For when the heart is cheerful, it cannot be filled with fear. And without fear, the way ahead seems more distinct and clear. And we realize there's nothing we need ever face alone. For our Heavenly Father loves us, and our problems are his own.
Thank you, Sister Gina. Be of good cheer. There is nothing to fear. That is a beautiful poem. Many times in the scriptures, Jesus told us, be of good cheer. When he went walking on the water and they became afraid, he said, be of good cheer, it is I. The man that was sick with the palsy, he said, be of good cheer, thy sins are forgiven. And we can be of good cheer tonight, knowing that our sins are forgiven. And he also said that in this world, we will have tribulation, but must be of good cheer because he have overcome the world. So despite what we may be going through this evening, whatever challenges we may have, we have no need to fear because we can put our trust in Christ. And we know that whatever comes to us as a child of God, he has to allow it. So we can keep our trust in Christ knowing that we have nothing to fear because whatever it is, God saw it and he's ahead of us and he will keep us. At this time, we're going to have a solo by Sister Sylvia. I love him too much.
Good evening, church. When I first heard of Jesus, his love and his grace, my heart was overwhelmed to think a king would take my place. I cried, Lord, I'll go.
Sister Sylvia, for that beautiful song. And you know, you have a beautiful voice, Sister Sylvia. I love to hear when you sing. I love him too much to fail him now. You know, we told him that we love him. It was easier to say, but harder to do. And yes, we acknowledge that sometimes it's easier said than done. But you know, we have a God who is understanding. And we know that when we fall down in Bakarto, when we make a mistake, we can go back to him and ask him and be open and just let him know and confess that we need his help and we can't do it alone. So the important thing is to know that we have a God that we can go back to. And whether you go back to him or not, he knows anyway. So it just makes sense to go back to him, acknowledge and ask him for help along the way. Thank you so much, Sister Sylvia, for that song. At this time, we'll have another poem by Sister Chastine, God Knows Best.
Good evening, church. God knows best. Our Father knows what's best for us, so why should we complain? We always want the sunshine, but he knows there must be rain. We love the sound of laughter and the merriment of cheer, but our hearts would lose their tenderness if we never shed a tear. Our Father often test us often with suffering and with sorrow. He tests us not to punish us, but to help us meet tomorrow. For growing trees are strengthened when they withstand the storm, and the sharp cut of a chisel gives a marble grace and form. God never hurts us needlessly, and he never wastes our pain, for every loss he sends to us is followed by rich gain. And when we count the blessings that God has so freely sent, we will find no cause for murmuring and no time to lament. For our Father loves his children, and to him all things are plain. So he never sends us pleasure when the soul's deep need is pain. So whenever we are troubled and when everything goes wrong, it is God working on us to make our spirit strong.
Thank you, Sister Chastine. God knows best. You know, when an airplane is flying and it hit a turbulence, it doesn't stop. It may take a detour, it may fly higher, or it may go lower, but one thing for sure, it doesn't stop. So when we're going through a storm, when we hit turbulence, you don't stop. You keep going through. There is glory in going on. I always try to remember Romans 8:28, during challenging times, and remind myself that as a child of God, whatever comes to me, God has to allow it. So whatever we're faced with, whatever we're going through right now, let us take comfort in remembering that God knows best, and it's okay to trust him. Even when it doesn't make any sense, we can still trust him. At this time, we're going to have another solo by Brother O'Leary, and that will be followed by a solo by Brother Lenny.
Good night, church. Psalms, one day at a time, sweet Jesus. I'm only human, I'm just a man. Help me believe in all I can be and all that I am. Show me the stairway I have to climb. Lord, for my sake, teach me to take one day at a time. One day at at a time, sweet Jesus, that's all I'm asking from you. Just give me the strength to do every day what I have to do. Yesterday's gone, sweet Jesus, and tomorrow may never be mine. Lord, help me today, show me your way one day. Well, Jesus, you know, as you're looking below, it's worse now than then. Cheating and stealing, violence and crime. So for my sake, teach me to take at a time, one day at a time, sweet Jesus, that's all I'm asking from you. Just give me the strength to do every day what I have to do. Yesterday's gone, sweet Jesus, and tomorrow may never be mine. Lord, help me today, show me your way one day. One more time, the chorus, church. One day at a time, sweet Jesus, that's all I'm asking from you. Just give me the strength to do I have to do. Yesterday's gone, sweet Jesus, and tomorrow may never be mine. Lord, help me today, show
evening, church. I can't help what others do. I'm on my way. Makes no difference how they scoff or what they say. I believe God just the same. Blessed be His holy name. I can't help what others do, I'm on my way. I can't help what others do, I must go on. Till I reach at last that bright eternal home that the Lord said He'll prepare. By His grace I'm going there.
I can't help what others do, I must go on. I can't help what Satan tries, he can't stop me. For I have Christ's Spirit dwelling now in me. And the one who dwells in me is a greater one than he. I can't help what Satan tries, he can't stop me. I can't help what others say, they can't hurt me. I'm a child of God, I know I've been set free. Jesus' name prevails for me over all my enemies. I can't help what others say, they can't hurt me. I can't help what others say, they can't hurt me.
Thank you very much, brothers, for those two beautiful songs, One Day at a Time. Tomorrow may never be mine. Sometimes people, when you ask people how they're doing, they say, oh, they're taking one day at a time. I smile and I say, well, that's good for you, because I can't take the whole day, I only got to take half. Sometimes you have some days where you're like, Lord, I just need you to help me just for this part, and you just keep going. And when you go home and you reflect, you realize, oh, I made it through the day. Thank you, Lord. So, yes, one day at a time, sweet Jesus. That's all. That's it. And we can't help what others do. We must go on. We can't help what others say. We must go on. I was helping someone with a project the other day, and a discussion came up, and I gave them the example. I said, you know, when we reach the heaven's gate and God look at me and say, well, Sister Latasha, I gave you this ability and I gave you this talent and this is what I wanted you to do and this is how I blessed you and this is why I blessed you this way, I can't look at him and say, well, God, you know. Because of Sister Darlene or Sister Kathy, I couldn't do it because they were talking about me and they were doing this and I couldn't do it, Lord. So you guys, I still have to go in because they distracted me and I couldn't do what I had to do. I said, you think the Lord will look at me and say, okay, Sister Latasha, come on in. I have to answer to God for me, for myself, for what I do in this body. So we have to remember that, yes, you must be concerned to a certain extent, but you can't help what others say in what others do. At the end of the day, this is a personal relationship between you and God. So yes, we have to continue going on, and there is glory in going on. So at this time, I'm going to take my prayer requests from this side. Special unspoken. Okay. Okay. Any requests from this side? Yes. Okay, Sister Bev. Sister Fifi, we have any prayers that came in? Okay. All right. I'm sorry, I didn't get her name. Sister Romella? Or a premier. Okay, yes. And choir?
And also pray for the children going off to college.
Yes, and also the children that are out on summer vacation, that the Lord keep their minds filled with good thing and they don't get, you know. Yes. Yes, and Brother Hank Mack for you. Okay. If all the prayer requests are in, I'm going to ask you all please to reverently stand, and I'm going to ask Brother Roy Ferron, please, if he would raise his voice and remember all the prayer requests.
When I'm so near to one distraught and weak
Our announcements are as follows. On Wednesday evening, we'll have our regular praise and worship service at 7 p.m. Saturday evening, we'll have prayer meeting at 5:30 p.m. And Sunday, again, our regular services with Sunday school at 9:45 and morning worship at 10:45 a.m. Our evangelistic service will be at 7 p.m. with chorus singing beginning at 6:45 p.m. Are there any additional announcements, Sister Ganita? Okay. Oh, morning worship starts at 11. I stand corrected. Thank you. At this time, we're going to ask the congregation to please stand, and we want to sing to the glory of God with all our hearts for those of us who have decided to follow Jesus and to encourage those who haven't decided to do so.
I have decided to follow Jesus. I have decided to follow Jesus. I have decided to follow Jesus. No turning back, Lord.
We have decided to follow Jesus by his grace and his mercies. No turning back. Yes, thank God. That's the best decision we could ever make. At this time, we're going to have a poem written by our very own and our very talented Sister Christine Wells.
There is glory in going on. There is glory in going on as we walk the narrow way. There is glory in going on, no matter what others may say. To reach the point of going on, we had to first make a start. And the only way that this is done is by welcoming Jesus in your heart. It's important for you to know that trials will still come your way, but no matter how hard the blow, remember Jesus is the way. A heavenly home is promised to all who keeps going and don't turn back. And even now, you can answer God's call and get your life on the right track. So as I take time to reiterate of the glory in going on, accept Jesus now before it's too late and come join the heavenly throng. You won't regret the choice you've made other than regretting that you waited so long. And remember what has been said, there is glory in going on.
Thank you very much, Sister Christine. I pray that the Lord will continue to bless you and that you'll continue to use your talent to glorify him. She said we must make a start, you know. So I ask you tonight, have you decided to follow Jesus? At this time, we're going to have a solo by Brother Leroy Daly. I'm coming up, and then that will be followed by another solo by Sister Georgian. Help me cross my bridges.
Praise the Lord.
Oh Lord, I'm striving to make it through this foreign land. But as I go from day to day, I can hear my Savior say, trust me, child, come on now. Thank you.
take away my trials. They only come to make me strong. Without them, dear Jesus, how would I get along? If I didn't have a problem, I never know my God deserved them. And I'll never know how faith could move my mountain. I've got bridges to cross, and I've got mountains to climb. I know I'll never make it on my own. Lord, I put my trust in you. There's nothing more.
Side. The Bible says all have sinned and come short of the glory of God. We all came up on the rough side. Might be smooth for us now, but yes, that's where we all started. So be careful how you knock people. Careful how you look down on people. Just remember that we all coming up on the rough side. And when you look at some people, Christians, they seem to be down in the valley more than they're up on the mountaintop. Don't knock them too hard. They're doing their best. They're coming up on the rough side. And I listen to that song, and I think about perseverance. You keep coming up. You keep coming, because we know what? That there is glory in going on. So you don't stop halfway and drop. You keep going. Thank you, Brother Leroy, for that beautiful song. And Sister Georgianne, help me cross my bridges. Yes, we can't do this on our own. We can't. We need each other. We need family. We need friends. We need fellowship. When God made Adam, he said it's not good for man to be alone. So if he knew that we could do this by ourselves, he would have left Adam. He wouldn't have given him no help. But we need each other, and more importantly, we need God. So, Lord, we need you to help us cross these bridges, and we acknowledge that we can't do this on our own. So thank you, Sister Georgian, for that beautiful reminder in song. At this time, we're going to have a duet by Sister Vida and Sister Babsy. Sisters, for that beautiful song. We're so thankful that God is the same yesterday, today, and forevermore, and we can continue to trust him. At this time, our last special will be by the choir, And they'll be singing I'm Heaven Bound. And that will be followed by a poem by Sister Miriam, If Jesus Came to Your House.
If Jesus came to your house, if Jesus came to your house to spend a day or two, if he came unexpectedly, I wonder what you'd do. Oh, I know you'd give him your nicest room to such an honored guest, and all the food you'd serve to him would be the very best. And would you keep assuring him you'd be glad to have him there? That serving him in your home is joy beyond compare. But when you saw him coming, would you meet him at the door with arms outstretched and welcome him to your heavenly visitor?
Or would you have to change your clothes before you let him in? Or hide your magazines and put the Bible where they've been? Would you turn off the radio and hope he hadn't heard? And wish you hadn't uttered that last loud, hasty word? Would you hide your worldly music and put some hymn books out? Could you let Jesus walk right in? Or would you rush about? And I wonder, if the Savior spent a day or two with you, would you go right on doing the things you always do? Would you go right on saying the things you always say? Would life for you continue as it does from day to day? Would your family conversation keep up the usual pace? And would you find it hard each meal to say a table grace? Would you sing the songs you always sing and read the books you read and let him know the things on which your mind and spirit feed? Would you take Jesus with you everywhere you'd plan to go? Or would you maybe change your plans for just a day or so? Would you be glad to have him meet your very closest friends? Or would you hope they'd stay away until his visit ends? Would you be glad to have him stay forever on and on? Or would you sigh with great relief when he at last was gone? It might be very interesting to know the things that you would do if Jesus came in person, came to spend some time with you. Jesus may not be coming to your house, but he's coming back into this world. Are you ready for that return? Are you purifying your life? Would you have something to hide if he returned tonight? Romans 12:1-2 says, I beseech you therefore, brethren, by the mercies of God, that you present your bodies a living sacrifice, holy, acceptable to God, which is your reasonable service, and do not be conformed to this world, but be ye transformed by the renewing of your mind, that you may prove what is good and acceptable and perfect will of God. May God bless each one.
I come to the garden alone, while the dew is still on the roses, and the voice I hear falling on my ear, the Son of God discloses. And he walks with me, and he talks with me, and he tells me that I am his own. And the joy we share as we tarry there, no other has ever known. You know, God may not physically show up to our house, but his spirit dwells within us, and he should always be there. So we should always be ready. We should always be prepared. We should always be in constant communion with him. That's what helps us make it through the day. Talking to him, asking him for help, seeking his guidance, always, always being in his presence. So that's something for us to think about when we think that if God would physically come to our house, and sometimes he shows up in a stranger, somebody may be homeless, somebody may be in need, he may show up in different ways. So we always have to be ready. So thank you, Sister Miriam, for that beautiful poem. And you know, the scriptures that she read from Romans 12:1-2 tells us that God expects a reasonable service of us. And we know that there are many movements and many organizations today that expect services of us, but it's not reasonable. We have to remember that we serve an understanding God and a reasonable God. And he tells us that we must not conform to this world, but we must be transformed by the renewing of our mind. That is not something that happens overnight. You have to be intentional, and you have to make a decision every day and throughout the day that you're not going to conform, and that you're going to renew your mind. So you have to stay in the Word, and that's something that you have to be consistent and regularly doing, renewing your mind. It doesn't happen all at once. So we thank God for His Word, and we thank God for the promises of His Word. We know that God calls us and God saves us, and He don't just save us and leave us by the wayside. He gives us the resources and the tools that we need to make it in this life and to make heaven our home. And we thank God for the promises of His Word. So this evening we endeavor to encourage you to go on and to remind you that there is glory in going on. Amen. Although the road is rough and the going gets tough, we have decided to make Jesus our choice. And for those of you that are in the audience and that are listening online who have not made that choice, we want to encourage you to do so while there's still time. And although we know that God is not slack concerning His promises, and He's long-suffering, not willing that any should perish, but that all should come to repentance, we must not presume on His mercies. For He also told us in His Word that His Spirit shall not always strive with man. So this evening, I trust that you were blessed. I trust that you were encouraged and inspired to glory in going on. We thank Sister Karen and Sister Chastine for putting this service together. And we thank you so much for taking the time out to come out and be with us. And we pray and trust that as you go through this week, you may remember that there is glory in going on. And whatever you may be faced with, maybe a song or a scripture from the service tonight, you will keep it in your heart, and it will help get you through whatever it is you may face this week. So we thank God for this. At this time, our closing hymn is going to be page 218 from our hymnal. Sister KK will lead us, and then I'll ask Brother Ray if he will come up and do the closing prayer, please.
Number 218, I mean to go right on. I mean to go right on until the crown.
Father, we are indeed so thankful that you met with us tonight, Lord, and help us all to be encouraged, Lord, to go on. Lord, no matter how hot the battle gets, heaven is our final destination. Help us, Lord, to think of all the good things that will be, Lord, and all the good things, Lord, that will last for eternity. Lord, eternity is a long time. Help us, Lord, to concentrate on heaven. Concentrate, Lord, on being with you and meeting you. So no matter how rough things get, Lord, on this earth, help us to have the strength, Lord, and the desire, Lord, and the faith in you, and the courage, Lord, to go on. Lord, sometimes we're moving slow, but we're still going. Thank you, Lord, for all you've done for us. Thank you, Lord, for the reminder, Lord, that no matter how rough it gets, that we're to enjoy this journey, Lord, that you've placed us on. Because, Lord, we're in a race. Sometimes we're running, sometimes we're walking, sometimes we're crawling. But we're going on. Continue, Lord, to be with us. Continue, Lord, to be with the church. Help us, Lord, as a body, Lord, of God people, to encourage the outside world to know that, Lord, we have a better thing. Lord, we have a better way for them. That, Lord, that they're not to be discouraged, but, Lord, we're to encourage them, Lord, that we have a good thing, Lord, in us. That's to serve you, and you'll always, always be with us. Lord, because you promise us you will never leave us. And you promise us, Lord, you will never forsake us. So we thank you, Lord, for those promises. Your promises can't fail, Lord, so your word can't fail. And we hold on to your everlasting words, Lord. Continue, Lord, to be with the church. Continue, Lord, to be with Brother James. Continue, Lord, to be with all of us, Lord, that is trying so hard to make heaven our home. Continue, Lord, to help us, to help others along the way. Is our duty, Lord, is our while on this journey, Lord. We are stewards to help each other along this way. So be with us. Give us a good week, Lord, ahead. Thank you, Lord, for Sister Karen, Sister Charles, and preparing this meeting. Thanks, Lord, for the way Sister Latasha conducted the meeting, Lord. Thank you, Lord, for everyone that participated, Lord. We have such great talent in this church. We just want to be quick to thank you, Lord, for all you've done and for all the members, Lord, you placed in our church. Continue, Lord, to be with us as we say thanks for what you've done and what you're going to continue to do. In Jesus' name, amen.